short on gold? Sell unwanted trinkets directly from your trinket inventory.
I'm not short on gold, though, so, I don't have to do that.
You answered the letter. Now, like me, you are a part of this place.
That's what I get for looking at my mail. Hello, housemates, and welcome back to the Dorkest Estate over the Darkest Dungeon. We got some more level 4s last time because we went on a veteran quest, and it worked. Good stuff. So we got lots of 4s, lots of 3s, some 2s, and then a single 1. Oh, Bellicote, you must feel so alone down there. We cannot expand our roster any further, as you can see. Oh, what's this? Experienced recruits provides a chance of higher level recruits appearing in Stagecoach. Sure. Okay. Instructor Mastery level 3. What the f- does that mean? That must be at the guild. Okay, so we need some more portraits to get more experienced recruits. That's probably been there for a while, I just hadn't noticed it. Because my roster's been full for a few weeks, so I had no reason to go over there. But we should look around from time to time, for sure, to see what's available. All right, so we have some level 2 folks, and we want to get them, we want to get everyone up to the level where they can fight veteran level bosses, and so that is at level 4, right? So let's work on getting all of our low people, raising them up. All right, so our two apprentice, we have a short apprentice and a long apprentice. I believe we will do the long apprentice. And of course, we're gonna take Gurney. What do you have? Yeah, you got some shit there. Do you have on self only. Oh yeah, so that'll be good actually. We can take her out, do some camping to get her in, get a disease off of our antiquarian there. So we'll take Bellicote, the front line, and then Grancor. And we're getting this Heaven's Hairpin, which will be good. Because in the veteran missions, we are more likely to be adventuring in high light. And so minus stress damage. Of course, there's less stress damage when the torchlight is that high anyway, but even more is great, plus that accuracy. So we're going to definitely go for this. Let's hop back and see if anyone needs to be upgraded. Gurney, you're good. Grancor, you're good. Peck off. All right, excellent. Now let's go to the guild. Let's just go ahead and upgrade all of her skills. She's kind of like the abomination in that you kind of want to upgrade all of her skills so that you can at all times freely arrange her into any position that you like. We're good with you. We've got a lot of movement. Both the highwayman and our grave robber can move back and forth if we equip their skills the right way. And of course, the crusader can move forth. So I think we will leave him this way, yes. With you, okay, good. We got lots of stuff we can do with you. We may want your, we'll definitely want your backward movement. We might want your forward movement, maybe not. Let's see, we do want more blight. Toxin Trickery is good, so she's in the third rank. Throne Dagger. We don't have anyone to do marking. This makes their bleed resist less. We don't really have a lot of bleed inflict. We could, but we're not going that way. So, Toxin Trickery we'll put up. That's 3 skills. Do we want to just have the lunge? So she can move forward, backward. Or this just does a lot of damage anyway, and it gives an accuracy buff. I think we should go with this one. All right, seems good to me. Oh wait, we didn't check on you. So with you, you don't have the Unholy Lance. Let's get that out. Let's just upgrade you all the way. We've got plenty of cash. And now let's go to the Survivalist. There are two camps here. We're going to save our crests. You have three camp skills. You do not. Produce a random supply item. Reduce stress. So there's a little chance that it'll increase stress by 10. Let's go for that one. That seems good. I like some gallows humor myself, personally, so I won't be offended. Okay, you're good. You're good. All right. So, let's embark. Let's provision. Okay, so, holy water from the Crusader, a shovel from the Grave Robber, two pieces of camp wood, of firewood, because it's a long mission. So, long missions. We don't have terribly good healing, so, you know, I'm gonna fill up my inventory. I know, I always do this a little bit inefficiently, excuse me. Four shovels. Yeah, I think that should be good. We have a little bit of everything. We can always ditch it if we need to. We have three inventory slots open. Let's embark.
The undead will not bleed, but they can be blighted.
Which I don't really understand either. How do you blight bones? I can understand how maybe you could blight some sort of fleshy undead, you know, give them some kind of bacteria that eats away the rest of their flesh, whatever.
Pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar, now foreign.
Okay, so this is explore. We have a lot, a lot of space to cover. We got a good scout at the beginning. We'll want to camp relatively early on. Let's just go deal with this room battle. We want to camp relatively early on so that we can free up that inventory space and get some buffs. Deal with the disease on our antiquarian. So let's see what we have in front of us here. Oh, holy, I'm really dumb. I entirely forgot to equip anyone with any type of artifact. Yikes. Well, it's too late now. Just totally spaced out today. All right, you are going to go forward. Well, that means we have lots of extra space for artifacts that we loot.
Give them no quarter.
It was not intentional, and it's not a good idea. So, my apologies. And this is just after, you know, the other day, someone put a comment on one of my videos that I was getting good at this game. I just had to prove them wrong. Getting worse. So that was the flash powder helping us out there. All right. Despite my idiocy, we remain, for the moment, unscathed. It's blight. Go ahead. See if I care. All right, we can only shoot the front rank. Nice.
Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Let's see. Let's accuse.
Another one falls.
Shift the blame here away from my stupid decisions to them.
Confidence
nice.
Surges as the enemy crumbles.
All right, we're already getting some good stuff. Glad
Remind
to see it.
All
right, let me rectify at least some of my mistakes. Let's see. Do we want you to have these things? Yep, that looks good. Do you have the skills that we wanted? We want you to have lunge, I believe. We wanted Shadow Fade in there somewhere. I think we wanted Shadow Fade. Yeah, that's what we wanted. You are good. And you, we wanted the Holy Lance. Let's try it instead of the heal. Okay. So, let's see if I can salvage this big time screw up. Luckily, this is an apprentice mission. If this were a veteran mission, I would be totally, totally out of luck, and I would get punished severely. As it stands, because we lack artifacts, that gives us a reason to keep the torch up a bit, since we don't have power boosts. So we will need instead to rely on surprise and the reduction of damage to us. Go ahead and blight this one back here. You're gonna take 4. Let's put some more blight on him. He should be dead now. Or he should be... Wait, why can't I move? So I have to be even further back to use this. Okay. Good to know. So that's a good reason to have lunge.
The slow death, unforeseen, unforgiving.
Yep, unforgiving. You don't deserve forgiveness for making a total blunder like I did. All right.
Back to the pit.
Yes, indeed. Let's get a little bit of healing. Okay. Nice. Oh, I'm gonna fire back.
Executed with impunity.
That be enough to take care of you? 4, yep. Okay, so more healing then. Shoot you.
Their formation is broken.
Okay.
Maintain the offensive.
Alright, so we need to make room for some things. Let's ditch these torches in order to get a stack of these. Remember, these can stack to 20, so that's super good. We're gonna keep our other torches, and we'll just deal with the fact that we can't take these at the moment. It's trapped, of course it is. She resists. Let's make it a couple more rooms before we camp. I should remember to have the antiquarian loot the stuffs. I don't know if it actually makes a difference. I've been told it has, but someone might have been lying or mistaken. Let's go ahead and clear out this hall as well. No! No spiders! Oh god. Die!
Be gone, fiend.
Spiders, my ancient foes.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Can I kill you? Not likely. It's right in your 8 eyes, dickhead. No. At least there's not another one of them to follow up on this marking. Die. Oh, eat a dick. No. Okay. At least it didn't go for the antiquarian. Die.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy.
It's pretty lucrative for fighting some spiders. Again, we're gonna leave this stuff as it is. See what our curio here is. So that's a shrine, which will give us some combat buff, which we need, given that we don't have items. All right, so let's go back down here. Remember, we're exploring 90% of rooms on a long mission. I think that means you can leave out 2. So we'll leave out these 2 down here, maybe. It might be more... there's not a particularly effective way to do this, no matter what, unfortunately. By effective, I mean efficient.
Okay. A fortune waiting to be spent.
Watch your step. All right, let's go ahead and make our first camp, get rid of some disease on our antiquarian to get some buffs and to free up some inventory space.
A spark without kindling.
Heal up a little bit. Our stress is now down to zero. Okay, so, snuffbox. I didn't equip our gallows humor because I'm a dumbass. Let's get rid of lethargy and vertigo. Nice. So it says remove target disease, but these skills almost always remove multiple diseases when they function. I don't know what the deal with that is, if it's intentional or not. So we have a plus scouting chance. I also forgot to equip. Oh god, I'm just so terrible at like this game. Blech. All right, let's do scouting and surprise stuff. Since we don't particularly seem to be having combat trouble, let's give ourselves other types of buffs. Minus 25% stress damage. So we can make him pretty good at combat. So let's do that. Yeah, that's right. Yep, we're prepared-ish. Yep, until my oversights get the best of you. Mm-hmm.
As the light right. gains purchase,
so let me now
and purpose is made
do
clear.
Things that I should have done. Equip that for the next time around. Equip that for the next time around. Equip that for the next time around. Do you want to change any of the skills? No. Okay. So, let's go. Ow.
Cruel machinations spring to life with a singular purpose.
Don't read it. All right, we're gonna go off to this spur. Got a scout. Gonna run up on some combat here. Yeah. All right, can you kill anything outright? Not terribly likely. Probably have to deal with one maggot attack. Yup. Ooh, but it missed. Excellent.
Be wary. Right. Triumphant pride.
Can use some holy water here.
Fall.
Ooh. Okay. Needed some healing anyway, and make room for the loot. All right, let's... We do want to get some scouting in, especially hopefully get some critical scouts to maybe find a couple of secret rooms. That would be good. I'd be happy about that. But no such luck yet. Nope. We got plenty of food, not worried at the moment. No, so many spiders. Die. Die.
Precision and power.
Good. All right, that's fine. It's not good. It's not my antiquarian. Yeah. Being a spider is a crime, punishable by
success,
death.
So clearly.
I mean, in real life, I like spiders. Giant spiders? No, thank you. They're always bad news in games. Okay. Oops. Whatever. All right. Yeah, that's right. No stress from you. Yeah.
Decimated.
Maybe I should put lunge on so that we can actually get him to the back rank for the, because this does extra damage against unholy, and we're fighting a lot of unholy stuff. Yeah, riposte.
Expedition at least.
Okay. I think let's just deal without torches. To use a couple.
The light. The promise of safety.
Get rid of them. Get this. Don't really want busts. Not the statue kind, anyway. Secret room? Nope. Well, let's just see what we can find.
If only treasure could staunch the flow.
Plus 10 damage, minus corruption. Dodge. Let's give that to you. Let's also move some people. And let's put your skill. Let's do that.
Some reward for a task well performed.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, surprised. All right. So no, we'll just try and get rid of him. Quite dead, unfortunately. There he is.
Annihilated.
Yep, if we'd have been smart enough to bring a paralyzer's crest, we might have stunned that dude. But instead, we're gonna get. It's gonna make it rain. Ooh, wow. Grand Core is not messing around.
The sharpened blade.
No, sir. Let's use some bandages here.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
Okay. So, it doesn't look like, I mean, we still have a little ways to go. We're not going to have find enough artifacts, trinkets, to kind of justify, ameliorate the fact that I forgot to equip anything on people. Because you could see how, if you were fairly certain that you could make it through without much injury, you could leave all those slots open just so you could bring more stuff home. Either to have a greater variety of trinkets, or, of course, to get more cash, because you could sell them off. It is a strategy which you might do intentionally, but which I did not do intentionally. Remember, we do have one more camp, so we can get some buffs and stuff back that way. We can reduce some stress if we need to. We can get a trinket from the camping skill of our antiquarian as well.
Secrets and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of this place.
Alright, let's go down to here. Do some fighting in the dark, see how badly it goes for us. And if it doesn't go badly, well then, we can try and, or if it does go badly, we can camp to get the light back up. If it doesn't go badly, we'll be fine. We'll get lots of loot. So let's flash powder this dude. This budget Wolverine. Now he can use his unholy lance. Aw, can only hit back there. Fine. Take that corpse. So she can do the shadow fade. Now we're back in position without having to waste any turns. Simply moving. It wasn't terribly effective.
As victories mount,
all right, here.
So too will resistance.
I'm just gonna keep things the way they are for the moment. We're gonna go ahead and camp after the next room battle.
Glittering gold, trinkets and baubles.
I do need portraits. So I think I will. I just need a couple portraits. Okay. Let's blight the hell out of party foul dude back there. Six. Oh, he's still not quite gonna die. Well, a waste of blight, but whatever. Want to avoid the stress, which would be significant at this darkness. Oh, you don't want to attack him. Oh, damn. Grand Cord is MVP of this, for sure. You should be toast. Yep. And then... bye-bye.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They
can. Alright, let's camp.
A moment of respite.
We have 10 food left, so that's pretty good. Almost everyone's stress is... is down. Alright. I want to prevent nighttime ambush. I want to get the scouting chance. We can produce a trinket. So let's see what we get. Wow. It can produce very rare trinkets. Well, that's interesting. Unfortunately, we can't carry this around on anyone. It would have been great if it were a very rare trinket of some other type, but it's good to know that you can get very rare trinkets out of that. That is, I mean, that's a reason just to do it. Because this is like a quest reward for the level of quest that we're on. So that's really impressive, actually. We already have one. We'll keep it around if we have the space, because it'll probably be worth a lot to sell. All right, so... we have four left. We'd have him clean his guns. Seems like it's probably good. can reduce self only. So this gives him damage to melee skills. That makes his melee better. We want to do his range because that's primarily what he does. So let's go for that. Okay. So we've learned something important about that produce trinket skill. I wonder if it has to do, if it's limited by the level of mission that you're on. So for instance, if you were on a higher level mission, could you get like a champion level trinket? That would be something, for real. Okay, where are we? We're right here. I don't think we're gonna have any trouble finishing out this quest. It's not gonna be as lucrative as our other long antiquarian missions, it seems. We haven't found a secret room yet, which is what really drives our profit. Oh, poor skeletons.
Victory, but a victory nonetheless.
We haven't looked at this curio yet, so let's do so. Okay, this is the go ahead and use this. Okay, we are getting a decent amount of cash. It's not like we're gonna come home empty-handed. But I don't think we're going to continue the trend of getting more each time we go out with the antiquarian. Last time, I think we got about 37,000 gold. I wouldn't expect to break 30 this time, because we haven't found a whole boatload of the tetrahedron things like every other time we've gone out. It's definitely some inefficient...
Heroes may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold.
Adventuring here. But... whatever. So all these other curios we've looked at. So we're gonna go back down here. Okay, we have only one snack left, so that could end up being a problem. I should make sure that I finish the quest. So I need to go to these two of these last four rooms, so that I can finish the quest and then adventure around at my own peril. Oh, secret room? No. All right, so we are now out of food. We ate twice in rapid succession there. I think we should be done with the quest after this, and so we'll probably just leave. Okay, let's throw back to him. This will work this time. Yep. Right in the heart there. It's rough. Damage over time on this guy. And some more. So both of their blight skills also reduce the blight resistance of the target, so it's double effective. Nice. Sorry, he's toast. But let's rub it in.
A victory. Perhaps the turning point.
Okay. Yeah, and as I said, we are done. Let's see. I'm really afraid that we're gonna starve. I wanna get to this next room with the treasure thing, hopefully, without starving. But there's really no way for me to tell whether that's gonna work.
Packs laden with loot.
All right, so these only stack to 5.
Supplies.
It's 1,000, so is that, let's ditch, we just have everyone drink one of these. Refreshing holy water. And it should last into this battle, not that it's necessary. Made it to this room at least. Okay. We have so little stress on us that I'm not particularly worried about it, even though we're in the nasty dark here. It's a sword, but lance is also a verb, so I guess that's what he's doing rather than what he's using. Here, smell this. It's like some rancid milk or something like that. Nice try, idiot. Okay, so this we can give to our crusader.
Push on to the task's end.
And we grabbed most of the rest of this. Let's go ahead and ditch this. Ditch this. Let's see what we get out of this chest. Okay. All right, let's see if we can make it into the next room without starving. Seems very unlikely. Confessional. Go in here, see what happens. Okay, that was cool. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah. Alright. Is there anything worth... Oh, can we just poke our heads out there? Get this? Anything good?
Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy.
All right, let's call it quits. So, it didn't turn out to be a problem, but I made a terrible error in not equipping any trinkets on any of my people. And those spaces did not turn out to be very necessary to bring home trinkets. We did break 20,000, not quite 30,000, but that's partially because we simply didn't find any of those secret rooms. So, it's not all my fault. All right, we got a couple people up to level 3. You got Weapon Tinkerer. It's helpful since he's lower level. Oh, you got the runs, no good. Natural Swing is good for you. Eagle Eye, very good for you. Clumsy, meh. Balanced, replaced Wheeled Adventurer. That's not great. Doesn't really matter where she is. So, all in all, not great, but not terrible either.
My obsession caused this great foulness, and it is shameful that I must rely upon you to set it right.
Okay, so let's see. Quasar became addicted to the rush of pain. Her flagellant replaced dark temptation, which is fine. Jacob Marley got rid of the worries. Digby was cured of scurvy and the wasting sickness. Cardinal is no longer satanophobic. Rashid is no longer claustrophobic. Excellent. So lots of personal growth and treatment and in our absence. Do we have enough of the paintings for whatever it is that I wanted? No. Here, this is what I wanted. Nope, I still need 2 more to get Instructor Mastery to let me get even more experienced recruits. So we got a level 1 apprentice. A level 1 a Hellion. So that's not quite good enough yet. We still want... There are 2 more levels of this. We need to do a lot of... gathering of heirlooms before that's going to be of any use to us. So we now have a Heaven's Hairpin. We got 2 things. Got some things that we can sell. We don't need a duplicate of this. Sell it for 3,000. Excellent. Don't need this. Do we already have... that's not even very good. We're going to sell that too. So, we made a little bit more cash right off the end from the things that we brought back. So, remember, we got a Blasphemous Vial from using a camp skill on the Antiquarian. Meaning, taking an Antiquarian on a long mission where there are 2 camps is even better, because you could get 2 of those, I think. Maybe not. Maybe it's limited 1 use per mission, but still, that's really good. I'm glad to have learned that. What do we want to... No, don't do that. Oh, I clicked the wrong goddamn button. I don't want to open you, photo booth. Get lost. So what do we want to do? We want to check out next time's mission. So what do we have here in the Warrens? We have a grave robber doodad. It's short, so there's no camping. Might not be worth it. What do we have in the ruins? Holy orders, meh. Heavy boots. Moon Ring, Berserk Charm, Leper Immunity Mask. So, nothing great. I'll probably go for this medium veteran one, just because it gives me these portraits that I need for an upgrade for the guild. So I think that's what we're going to look at next time. A lovely veteran mission, medium, 1 camp. So, hopefully you enjoyed this video, despite my flub at the beginning. It turned out fine. If you did, please hit that thumbs up button, and if you want to see more dungeon diving from the Dorkest Estate, then please subscribe to my channel. If you're not going to do any of those things, then of course, I don't care what you do.